In recent times, the performance of the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, EFCC, comes under scrutiny by individuals and groups in both private and public sector. While some have lauded their performances and advocated for more power and resources to be given to the agency, others say the commission should focus mainly on investigative authority, which is their core responsibility. One of such parties advocating that the agency functions better without adding more responsibility is the senior advocate of Nigeria, Ahmed Raji.
When you look at EFCC, EFCC is mainly an investigating authority. When it comes to the prosecution of the offenses, I think there are bodies that are better equipped. And a situation, I mean, in any system that does not have a room for checks and balances, you may likely run into abuses. So if one arm investigates, let another independent arm evaluate the result or the report of that investigation and determine whether it is something we can carry to court or not. But where the same body looks after, investigates, prosecutes, and perhaps even wants to judge, that will make a mess of the system. So it is not in any way a bad comment on EFCC, but it is to enable EFCC to function better without adding more to what they are doing. For example, the Department of State Security has been trying to prosecute in court. But when you look at some of the prosecutions they have handled, you will see that while they are excellent in investigating and gathering intelligence, when it comes to prosecution, it's a bit not so well, because there's something they call outsourcing. Let everybody do what he knows best. Let EFCC confine itself to investigation. In the course of the investigation, they may need lawyers to guide them, internal lawyers or other experts in other fields. But when it comes to courtroom theatrics, that is better handled by either the DPP's office or an agency. And that is why some people have advocated that there is the need, urgent one in this country, to separate the office of the Attorney General from that of Minister of Justice. Let the Attorney General be a non-politician, a career person, appointed with a fixed tenure, who can look anybody in the face and file charges in court, and not a minister of government who is there on the patronage and who perhaps knows next to nothing about some of the issues touching on some complex prosecutions which the office may have to superintend. So, in a way, when you look at that proposal and you look at what the president of the bar said, I think a synergy can arise if we separate the office of the Attorney General from that part of the Minister of Justice, and we also ensure that some of these bodies, highly respected bodies, EFCC no doubt is done very well. DSS, they are doing an excellent job, but let them do what they know best and not combining other things that may make them look incompetent or a bit not focused. Because when they dabble into other things that they are not well equipped. And another argument, like I've said, is that there is the need for checks and balances in the system.
Mr. Raji also speaks on why there has been no convictions despite all the cases filed before the commission.
Perhaps some of the cases ought not to have been filed in court. If it is an independent body that is now determining which one to prosecute and which one not to prosecute, maybe some of those cases would not have gone to court. But because, oh, I have investigated, I must see it through, I must carry it out, then desirable and undesirable end up in court. So where does that lead us? And I do know very well, if it is, when it comes to investigation, I give EFCC credit. They are doing wonderfully well. They are doing excellently well. You can hardly fault them. But to go and prosecute, I think they should better leave, allow others to do that. Otherwise, the same body may say, okay, we are going to investigate, we are going to prosecute, we are going to judge, we are going to put them in prison, and we are going to do everything. Would that be good for the system? I don't think so.
He adds his voice to the issue of plea bargaining, as well as immunity for the principal members of the House. He says only the president and his vice should be given immunity.
A plea bargain is a modern-day necessity. It's a way of being pragmatic, because there are some cases that you may not just be able to conclude in court, that it is better even for the state to find a means of resolving it by way of a plea in exchange you forfeit some things and then you get your freedom and then you move on, because some of them may continue forever if you are not careful. So in the interest of the state, it may be desirable to find a means of terminating it. So if it is properly utilized, it may serve to decongest and then make the criminal trial degree of results may be achieved, but not when it is abused. It all depends. It is not in all cases, and when you look at the new law, it's not so easy now to profit from your plea bargain, which is the fear of the people. If you are alleged to have stolen maybe 1 billion naira, it is no longer the case that you are going to return just 2 million naira and then go and pocket now 98 million naira. So I think substantial part of it, if not the entire money, will be forfeited under the new regime. So under the new Administration of Justice, Criminal Justice Act, the whole of idea of using plea bargain to encourage corruption is gone, if it is faithfully implemented. Because from what I read there, it is no longer possible to keep a chunk and then walk away with a pat on your back. It's no longer possible. The whole idea of immunity is to allow them to concentrate so that they will not be distracted by frivolous suits. But there's the school of thought that, look, what is all this immunity about? What is it about? That the whole thing should be cancelled. And we shouldn't find it in our statute book. Because if you are in the office and you commit or you misbehave, you should be made to, you should be amenable to the laws. You should not see yourself as being above the law of the land. So perhaps if that is the misbehavior pervading the entire land space will be reduced to the barest minimum. So therefore, in the light of that, I do not think extending immunity to the principal officers will advance anything better for this society. Rather, I think maybe the immunity should just be limited to the president of the country and the vice president. But governors, deputy governors, I don't think they deserve to have immunity, as far as I'm concerned.